coming to you from my barn garage. I usually fit like 9 cars in here. We have made some really big moves. You've seen some of these cars a whole bunch of times. Paul Walker's personal E36 M3 lightweight. My mom's Mini Cooper. I love this car, guys. You guys don't get it. This car, baby. Rhonda, if you're watching this, my wife, this is the car that we need to drive around in. T-top 79 Trans Am. Come over here. I got 1,000 horsepower Turbo S. I got Rhonda's Tech Art 800 horsepower Turbo S. I've got cars in Southern Utah. I've got cars out of the state. In fact, the Pagani is currently out of the state. And here's the big announcement, guys. The Koenigsegg is gone from the garage. It has fled the coop. It has moved on to greener pastures. I know I'm gonna get some angry people, you know, like, what are you doing? It's a Koenigsegg, okay? We tried to have a good relationship together, okay? We tried to be business partners. We were in startup mode, the Koenigsegg and I, and sometimes, guys, these relationships just don't last, okay? So I have kept the Pagani. I have brought in two new cars, two new hypercars for that matter, that we're gonna introduce you to here shortly to replace the Koenigsegg, okay? But let me walk you through how I even acquired the Koenigsegg. So I have a good friend that's in the car business. In fact, I've done a business with a whole bunch of people that I've become really good friends with. But this guy, his name is Gabe. He helps out at We Are Curated in Miami. I told him, Gabe, I really want to try a Koenigsegg. Like, it's always been on my radar. I can't seem to find the right one because I wanted one with a manual transmission. It was about a year and a half in the making. I was like, Gabe, have we identified a Koenigsegg yet? Have we identified a Koenigsegg? And he's like, listen, Ron, I know where all three Koenigseggs are that fit your description here in the United States. I've been making calls to these guys over and over and over again. And finally, one day, I get a call from Gabe, and he's like, listen, man, I finally convinced this gentleman to part with one of his Koenigsegg CCXRs in manual. And here's the really cool part about this car. It was the car in Fast and Furious 5. So if you remember the scene, I'll tee this up for you really quick. They pull the heist. They all have all the money in the world that they'll ever want. Ludacris is working in his shop, and Tyrese pulls up in this Koenigsegg CCX, and he's like,
only 4 of those cars in the whole world. I got the only one in the Western Hemisphere.
So Ludacris says,
okay, I'll drive.
And right as he says that, a second Koenigsegg CCXR pulls up. And that was my car. Okay, so in the scene, my car looks different, okay? Because what happened with that car after it was in the movie is that the owner took it and he sent it back to Sweden for Koenigsegg to install the ghost package on it, which consisted of different aero, different blacked out bits, and they also installed an Agera suspension on the car. Once Gabe convinced the gentleman that owned the CCXR to part with it, I took a chance on this car. I had never been in a Koenigsegg, I'd never driven a Koenigsegg, but I was convinced to buy the Koenigsegg. We brought the car in, and specifically, I knew this was the first Koenigsegg that had ever been in Utah before, or at least owned in Utah before. And so I wanted to leverage this opportunity to raise money for one of my very favorite charities in Utah. So we revealed the car in front of, I think, 350 people. We had like 350 donations to the Foster Care Foundation. We raised more than $200,000 last December, and that was the largest single donation that the Utah Foster Care Foundation had from private individuals last year. And that is what began my Koenigsegg ownership experience. I don't know what I'm saying. So let's take a quick trip down memory lane of my ownership experience with the Koenigsegg CCXR. Dude. Picking up the Koenigsegg. So this is the first time I'm seeing it. You also have to hold down the Koenigsegg shield again. This car is not made for people that have lost fingers in like snowblower accidents. Thank you. tell you exactly why I sold the Koenigsegg, but first, I want to tell you what I loved about the car. The car is really unique. It's got these, like, you know, dihedral doors, and I always say that wrong, so I'm not actually sure what they're called. But they're these doors that don't come up quite. They kind of swing out and up. They're really unique. So the car, I think, itself is just a really unique proposition in the world of hypercars. The transmission, as I've mentioned multiple times, is phenomenal. It's a twin supercharged V8 that ran on E85 biofuel, like I have right there. So I had to get special fuel for it, which you might say, oh, that's kind of a pain in the butt. I actually thought it was kind of cool. I'm like, wow, this is the first car that I've ever had, you know, that ran on E85 biofuel. It made 1,000 horsepower. I think the looks of the car are phenomenal. Like, it, when you sit in it, the windshield wraps around you and you feel like you're driving a fighter jet. I also loved the suspension on this car. And the reason is most hypercars are so difficult to drive every day, but the Koenigsegg was like plush and supple, and when you pushed it, it stuck to the road. And I really think the Ghost package helped because we put that extra wing on it, some additional aero pieces. The car was certainly a performer, but it's a car that you could probably drive every day. I think I was too big for the car, 6'3", 230 pounds. That's too big for that car. I think someone around 5'9", 5'10", 180 pounds, like, probably fits substantially better in that car than I did. I owned the Koenigsegg for 6 months. We did a ton with it in that time. I put a ton of miles on it, drove it as much as I possibly could. We showed it at Exotics at the Gateway. More than 10,000 people got to see that car. 350 people up close and personal at my Utah Foster Care Foundation fundraiser got to experience it. Many of you got to sit in it. I had several people drive it. So I used the heck out of it while it was here. Cars come and cars go. I am not, you know, stuck on any one single car. I love certain cars. I think the 911 Turbo S is like the best all-around daily supercar performance kind of a vehicle you can possibly drive, right? I've had really great experiences. The Koenigsegg was so fun to own for this period of time. And honestly, when I saw it leave the driveway, I breathed a sigh of relief. So in summary, I had a great experience with the Koenigsegg. Yes, it was short-lived, but I think more people saw the Koenigsegg than any car that I have ever owned. And I was really happy to share it with as many people as possible. The two new cars that are inbound to replace it, that have already landed actually, are gonna blow the Koenigsegg out of the water. Super excited to have these two new hypercars enter the garage. We are gonna be filming a ton of content with it. Stay tuned on those, subscribe. If you wanna experience a couple of really wild hypercars, we are gonna put them through their paces. We are gonna do some private track days. We're gonna do some drag battles. We're gonna do some top speed things. We're gonna show, you know, let anyone that wants to see them at some of these fun events. Stay tuned. I'm gonna extend some invites. You're gonna wanna attend. In memoriam of the CCXR. Aww.